Yes, normal ABS. At least I think it is. But yeah, it's okay. Yeah, we're started, I think. Okay. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to a friendly match between Glow and 3AC. I am joined by a guest today, going by the name of Winter Monkey, or so his coworkers call him. Welcome, Winter Monkey. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well. How about yourself, Smithers?
Good, good. I'm excited to cast another game here. The game hasn't started yet, for those of you tuning in. We are waiting for everyone to file in here. It'll be a 35 versus 35 on Carentan, with the Glow being Axis and 3AC being allies. Glow
is... I don't think you're live.
What's that? Sorry?
I don't think you're live.
Oh, it's a 15-minute delay. 15 minute delay.
Oh, 15 minutes.
Yeah, 15 minute delay. So, yeah, it's should be a good one. I've had a pretty good day today. For those of you that are football fans, the Cleveland Browns are in the playoffs, so that is pretty exciting. I also solved a programming bug that has been bothering me for the past 2 weeks, so that is also pretty exciting. So it's been a great day, and I hope the energy comes across in this cast. So, cheers to that. And Winter Monkey, what would you say you want the point to be here for the opening? What do you think you want here? We got Town Center, Canal Crossing, and then we're going to have Derailed Train at the bottom there. So what do you think? You want like a mid-battle over Town Center? Do you want Derailed Train maybe for the opening tank battles? I guess Canal Crossing is also tank battles, but what you thinking? What you thinking?
See, if they do go with Town Center, it is going to be quite an interesting fight, because depending on who really gets a hold of Town Center, if they can get their support players in there and they can get some good supply drops on there pretty early on and can get a good foothold in Town Center, you can essentially hold that place for a very long time by blocking off some crucial like roadways and kind of just creating a funnel for infantry to be only able to push that center in like one direction. So Town Center is definitely going to be a very strong point in this match, if it is the center point.
Yeah. I think yesterday we saw Canal Crossing, and I think I want Town Center. I want to see some brutal infantry close-to-close fighting here, and I want to see those tanks go down these alleyways. And plus, once you have Town Center right, you really open up the map to a lot of different attacking from different directions, right? So
that is very true.
Yeah.
I would also really like to see some good tank battles this match.
Yeah.
I myself am the tanker.
Yeah, I think Town Center is going to be, if it's Town Center, we'll see some battles at the church. And then, of course, the opening medium battle, it's going to be who's going to squeeze that first shot around, with the Axis most likely having their tank here, right? And then the ally medium will be over here. So, but maybe they'll switch it up. But then, of course, got to think about the infantry push, because that infantry push could easily get that medium on either side out of the Town Center. So, but go ahead, sorry.
Oh, yeah. I was just going to say, that is one thing that I like about tanking and also dislike about tanking, is especially with this map, when it comes to tanking on Town Center, you got to have that infantry support. Because if you don't have support of your infantry, you're pretty much a sitting duck, and lasting in Town Center without that infantry support is like a death sentence.
Yeah, 100%, 100%. And this, the famous Jim Bonian once said, how could infantry allow this to happen? So... We do have a map flip, ladies and gentlemen. We will be going live in 45 seconds. The point is currently on Town Center. Will it be Town Center after the flip here? We shall find out. Should be a good one. Once again, Glow versus 3AC. 3AC has a couple subs from Broken Arrow, it looks like. I don't know. They do have the 3AC tag with them too. But they got a few mercenaries playing with them today. So it should be a good one. I have no idea how long this match will last. Yesterday was a 90-minute match between VLK and Glow, with Glow winning 3-2 with Canal Crossing as the midpoint. So here we go. Here's the map flip.
Let us see.
Let's see what we got.
If I remember correctly, aren't we, isn't the Glow team kind of on a winning streak right now?
They sure are. They are on a bit of a winning streak. I thought Glow was access today. Okay. Glow is allies. Let me just go ahead and pick myself.
Hello?
Little infantry squad here. Okay. We are live. The midpoint is Canal Crossing. Here we go again.
There we go. That is a good midpoint.
I was hoping for Town Center, but looks like we're going to see the... Yeah, okay. It's okay. Let's see what happens here. Let me go ahead and clean up the screen here. So Glow is very familiar with Canal Crossing after 90 minutes of a slugfest yesterday. Let's see how they approach this one, if they approach it any differently here. So we got the opening trucks. We got all three tanks in. Doesn't look like... okay. Well, the extra tank will be about 1 minute 30 if they're going to spawn that. So. Who do you think has the advantage on midpoint for Canal Crossing?
Let's see. I definitely say the allies definitely have the more of an advantage on arriving there at Canal Crossing. There's no really, they pretty much have like a, looks like a direct path there. They don't got a lot of obstacles in their way. Don't have a lot of bridges to cross in order to get to that point. While on the other side, they kind of got that waterway kind of in their way to be blocking them, and they'll have to go around to take certain routes to it. And if the allies know those certain routes, they can definitely set up like artillery to kind of start hammering that right off the beginning to make it a lot more difficult for them to try to push in.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. I mean, the Axis have to deal with the sort of confined roadways. And as you said, allies have a lot more open space to work with, right? So, and then the opening medium, I mean, the Panzer IV is going to be confined to that road, and maybe it'll go north to customs. I don't know. But, yeah, the allies have a lot more space to work with. So that's going to be, and then of course, VLK yesterday did not put a Gary up here, which was kind of surprising in the beginning. But they did, however, sink a Tiger in the canal here by trying to cross the bridge. I wonder if 3AC...
Were they trying to cross on the boats?
They were trying to cross on the boats here. They sure did.
I did not know that was possible.
They sank that puppy right here.
Oh, dude.
So hopefully 3AC saw that, and we'll learn from that. But let's see how this opening works out here.
Yeah.
We got an opening...
This is quite a risky move to try to bring a tank across those boats.
Yep, yep. We have 3AC opening supply drop in that spot up here. Okay. Let's see how this works out. Starting to see the first truck come in. Truck down there in the top left coming in.
I do see that.
Don't see any rocket snipes today. Artillery mark going down.
Shells haven't... Oh, here come in the shells from that already.
Oh, I think that was just a rocket snipe. That was the... yeah, that was the road they tried yesterday.
Oh, right.
Yeah, Artie's coming in right now, I think. Here we go. First action about to be seen.
Ooh, look at those shells coming in.
Yep.
Both sides. Don't know if that is also the enemy shells falling down on the opposite side where the allies are pushing. Or if that is the,
I think that was the truck. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that was the truck. The truck just got destroyed by the enemy artillery, looks like.
Got The Greyhound.
You got that recon. Yeah.
Oh, ooh, a long rocket shot takes down the Greyhound.
It's taken out quickly. That's definitely going to be a bit of a setback for them.
Peck Rex over here with the long range Panzerschreck shot. Nice job, buddy. That is beautiful.
Ooh, nice long, long shot. Like, might have came from wheelchair over there. Looks like they've got a Luke's firing upon them. We saw some. Comes another rocket in. I think that one hit the dirt. I'm not sure. I fell short. That's what happened. He's backing up. He's definitely hurt. Definitely took one of those rockets from him.
Lux is going to be hugging behind the building here, probably waiting to see where the medium is. Let's take a quick opening map view here. We have the Stuart in the north with Zoomer, Trots, and Sarcasm. Medium is down by the riverbank. And I think that's, yeah, okay, yep. And then the Greyhound was just destroyed, so. Solid map control to begin. But the Axis do have the bridge, or the, the northern part here. We should see this Gary go up by, yeah, okay, Gary's up. Gary's up in the corner here. Very good, very good.
Ooh, see that light tank of the Allies pushing up that road. I wonder if that Lux has spotted it. He is facing him in that direction. Oh, there's a medium coming up. Now that's the light tank there. I don't know if he knows if that Lux is hiding behind that house.
Maybe, yeah.
He's spotted right here.
Yeah, I think he's going to see the smoke. Oh, he's probably
do they see him?
Yeah, he probably sees the fumes of smoke going over the building, I imagine. Oh, one shot.
Oh, there he goes. They got one shot into that Lux. He's really hurt now. I think the Lux is starting to panic a little bit. It's that Stuart's pushing. He's more focused on the infantry. I don't even know he knows that tank is pushing him. That Lux is doing a number on him.
Ooh, we have a Rick in the front. This is the thing that I struggle with. I have no idea where to hit this Lux in the front. Lux or Lux, whatever you want to call it. Let's see how many Ricks they're going to have in the front here.
Oh, ricochet off the rocket, too. That Lux just does not want to go down. Another rocket. That one looks like it might have hit its tracks there.
Alright, I think I counted... There's a very specific...
Another one!
There's a very specific spot in front of the Lux in which you have to hit.
Yeah.
And I'm not 100% sure where that is. And I know our dear friend Wix was trying to describe it to me. It's a very, very specific spot. This Stuart's going to need to go.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay. Like,
oh, there it goes.
Okay, gotcha.
Also, that light tank looks like he's going to be in a bit of a trouble too here if he can't get out of here.
Yeah, there's smoke.
Might
him,
be okay.
Clutch smoke there. I think somebody threw smoke on the tank, but that was to mask it? Is it Wix? I don't know. Somebody threw a smoke nade on the tank, though.
Oh, Wix just goes down, gets taken out by the minister right there. He is an engineer. I wonder if he's gonna have a satchel on him to try to go for that tank.
Yeah, let's go give some, let's go figure out where the enemy, the P4 is already taken down on the road here.
Oh, wow.
I missed that. Oof. Oh, we got a Panther up. Okay. All right. Panther is up.
Do have a Panther now. He is sitting back a little bit. Got that house is providing him cover. Good move.
Do we have a 76 on the board yet? I don't think we do.
Oh, no, we do. I think he's just coming up from top spot.
Oh, okay. Yep. Okay.
There
yep.
he is.
176. Panther is marked. Let's go give some love to the guys on the southern flank here. Who be dropping supplies, redeploying right away like a pro?
That is one thing I've also learned more and more when I've been playing this game, is learning about, you know, dropping supplies, getting off so somebody else can take it.
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, especially in intense, mega intense con matches, support is just so key. Just drop, drop your supplies real quick, redeploy. So especially for red zone carries, we're gonna need 2 boxes, right?
Right.
So yeah, it's just so key to get support in a timely manner. 3AC is cleared. Complex here, and are pushing into southern part of the point. But already, oh no, okay, I think that was, yeah, okay. What kind of viewpoint does city have up here? Let's take a look. What you doing up here, city? What you looking at, buddy? Okay, you could see some stuff. Can you see much? I don't know if you could see much.
I don't know. That house might kind of block some of the way.
Yeah.
Might have had a pretty good view kind of into the compound a little bit to see if anybody was coming in through that way.
Yeah. I wouldn't expect not that many kills, maybe. Unless they get breakthrough up there or something, right?
Right.
But already smashing the front door here.
Whiskey. Definitely good call outs for those already marks.
Yeah, for sure. Whiskey Tango smashing the front door, keeping them at bay. Let's go see what's going on south here. Pretty decent push. Since yesterday the point was customs for the fort, and today we have rail crossing, so I think we're going to see more, a little bit more action on the fourth point versus yesterday with potential cap, because 3AC is going to have to extend their line and to defend this, right? So
right.
35s or 35s, your resources are very limited.
Yeah. I do say, I do think these last 2 points here are going to be a little bit more beneficial for the 3AC. It's definitely a lot easier for them to access.
Yeah, for sure.
Especially with Canal over there, Canal locks.
Scrimshanks moving in.
Wonder if he's looking for a good spot to place down another garrison or possibly even an OP for his group. Yeah.
He's going to put it in a nice little nook and cranny right here. Look at that. Perfect. Nice little safe space. Nice job there, Scrooge.
Nice and hidden.
Let's watch him peek this corner and follow him down this alleyway into the front door. He goes.
Takes one guy out that was in the middle of the road. Check to see if there's anyone else around.
Noxy? I think that was his name. Noxy? Gary's going down. Fart, Dank Nugs.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hey, guys. Come on now. Watch. Children's chat. Children's chat.
Family friendly.
Exactly.
Let's go.
Family. Panther.
See, oh, looks like we've got a Panther pushing down.
Panzer 4. Panzer 4.
Oh, it's actually 4.
Yeah. From the distance, it fooled me.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay, Panzer 4 is coming in to stabilize the defense here.
Yeah, looks like that B4 took out that little group there.
Yep. But the Gary is down.
They need to get a backup garrison. Don't know if they have any supplies around to be able to do that.
Yeah.
Kind of looks like they were caught off guard just a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, 3AC has no front. Their front door is very weak right now, but the Panzer 4 is in the point. Pop Dart coming in. He has a satchel loadout for sure. He hears it. He's looking.
If that tank will notice him.
He's looking. Oh! Nope, he's not sure. He has a satchel loadout, right? Yeah, grease gun. Okay. Pop-Tart. You know,
speak to the corner, see where that thing is looking.
I've never asked Pop-Tart if he had to choose a flavor. Which one would it be?
Maybe we'll have to ask him back here.
Yeah.
But, ooh, a rocket comes in right in the back of that P4. I wonder who it was that shot that.
I'm a big fan of brown sugar and cinnamon.
Oh!
Yeah, the good classic. Never go wrong
with it. Oh, and Pop-Tart is going to get the satchel.
Pop-Tart's going in for the satchel. Is he going to actually get it off here?
Oh!
Let's see it. Oh, he gets the satchel off, and the P4 is unaware that they've just been satcheled.
Pop-Tart with a clutch satchel. Middle of the points. Tank crew has no idea. Oh
yeah, that Trank Guru is unaware of that satchel. Hopefully Scrimshake doesn't push up too close.
Yeah, he's sticking back. He knows.
Oh, and down.
And there it goes. The PZ4 is down thanks to Pop-Tart there.
Nice job, Pop-Tart. Got that all on camera for you, buddy. Rail crossing being capped. Panzer IV no longer in the strong point for that defensive cap pressure. Token? Not toxic, but token. Or token. Could be token.
Token.
Could be token. Token versus toxic. Still a little bit of cap pressure. Let's watch this point from above here real quick. Let's see what we got
here
going.
Here comes a bombing run. Is that now the enemy bombing run or is that the friendly?
Ooh.
The allies.
That is an ally bombing run. Ally bombing run.
That did take out that group there. Left one guy there. It's just baked.
Wow, I was going to say BKD. That's too funny. That's how out of touch I am.
Baked for life. Pretty sure that is what he's going with. I could be wrong.
Yeah, I was looking at it going, BKD for life. Okay. I'm assuming that's an acronym for something. But who knows?
Be. I wonder if him and Token are friends.
Yeah, exactly.
Bet you they're in the same squad there.
Ooh, close.
Ooh, the lieutenant gets taken out. I wonder where he got shot from.
We have a Jeep on the southern end. Rail crossing being capped.
Three looks ace. Like there is some pressure also coming on to Canal crossing. Oh, looks like there was. Looks like they just cleared it.
Rail crossing is at 80% capped. And 3AC still has couple bodies up at Canal or Customs. This point's gonna go to Glow.
It sure looks like it.
Yep.
Ooh, it looks like they got some artillery coming down. I don't know if that is their artillery or if it's the allies coming down.
That is probably, yeah, I was going with the Axis, but let's take a look at, could this be a quick 5-0 Glow with strong point presence, squad lead, toxic, and dank nugs in the circle. Mick fucking. Oi, it's Mick fucking.
It's Mick fucking.
Oh, I love that name. That is great. I love your name. Awesome. I love your name, buddy. That's really good. That's really good.
Aaron setting something up here.
We have the allies' Jeep coming in hot, flinging the
is
white
he
helmet.
Get roadkill.
Oh
no, he's gonna get the bolt. Is he going to? Oh no, Flig manages to kill the enemy commander. Commander versus commander there. What are the odds?
Oh my God.
That was just nutty. He comes in hot with that Jeep.
Oh, that was so cool. That was great.
Good job to Flig there.
Yeah, that was really clutch. I don't know if 3AC has any spawns up here. We have, actually a lot of glows are still not in the circle, so this could easily go back to 3AC here. I don't see this being a 5-0 right now. This Panther should get up in the circle and stop the cap. He's just got a little. Oh no! Don't stop, dude. What are you doing? You gotta go.
No.
He's gotta get in the circle. He's gotta get in the circle.
Need to push into that circle. Just sitting right there on the edge of it.
Oh no. Okay, one goes down. Can 3AC save this? I don't know. Okay, the tank's pushing up. Okay, contested. Okay. All right. They should save this now. I'm guessing the tank crew was yelled at to get in the circle.
I definitely would be yelling at them to get into the circle.
The tank is actually still not in the circle here. It is right. I think he's right on the edge, yeah. Okay, but they have... What do they got here? They got a Puma... And then they got the Panther. Okay. Satchel goes off, clears the building. 3AC needs to stabilize here, though. Let's take a look at rail real quick. We got the Stewie to the south. No real potential here for 3AC at the moment. Oof, doggy. That was close.
That was a very close one. And it does look like they might be taking back the next point. Was that? Or did I just see that wrong?
No. They still got the full cap. Or they still, it's just still, I don't know. I didn't see a flicker. Maybe I missed it. But 3AC almost, taking it back. That airhead coming in very clutch in the top right.
Let's see if they will spot that airhead.
Yeah, they gotta know that something is leaking in. Because it's glows now just flooding in.
Meister over there. It's getting rid of the face on that little group that probably just spawned off that airhead coming in.
Yeah. Toxic. Getting a shot in the Panther's ass. Oh! Yeah, the tank was turning just a little bit there.
Was able to get one rocket in. Yeah. Any damage will help.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Get them freaking out. Get them on the move. Looks like our tank is now engaging that Panther. Allies tank.
Oh, it is. I missed it. Ooh, takes it down.
Oh, and they just took that Panther out. That's going to be a huge blow. Yeah. And it looks like they're going to take this point now.
That just might be a wrap. Sub 30 minutes.
Wow. I was kind of hoping this would kind of go on just a little bit longer.
Yeah, me too.
Was a quick one.
Me too, but Glow has solid strong points. Control. 3ACs out of the sector. It's a very, very tight sector for Cap. And... Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that is a wrap on Carentan.
Yeah.
Sure is.
All right.
Let's see if they're going to run it back. I don't know if they're going to run it back.
Oh, there is talk about it in chat to run it back.
Yeah.
It would be pretty fun. Just run it back for funsies.
That's true. Let's see. Okay, we'll stick around. We'll see if... See if 3AC is leaving. Okay, 3 AC is taken off. Okay. So that appears to be it, I believe. Yeah, okay. All right, well, thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. Let me go ahead and turn that music volume down a little bit. Okay, there we go. Thank you for joining us. It was a quick match. Probably be streaming again in the near next weekend, probably. I'm guessing we have more matches. Not 100% sure. Do you know?
I believe there might be more matches coming in this weekend. I'll have to take a look at the schedule here. See if anything's updated or posted about it.
Yeah, let me see. Saturday. Okay, yeah, next weekend. Okay, yeah, the match, I guess, is to be decided. Oh, well, there's 75th and Wolf. Okay, just 18 versus 18 and Wolf, but 35 versus 35 versus 75th. Okay, so next Sunday, there'll be another match. Okay, cool, unless there's something else scheduled. All right, well, yeah, sorry for the quick match, everybody, but that's a wrap. Thank you for joining us. And Winter Monkey, any final thoughts on this one?
Yeah, I'd say the Glow teams, I was kind of surprised how fast they were kind of just moving through the points, and looks like they were working really well together. Definitely were well coordinated, definitely had a plan going in. I am kind of hoping that there would be a little bit more of a fight going on. Everyone played really well. Definitely some good plays on both sides. And I definitely look forward to making it to the next match and see how well it goes.
Yeah, Glow on, once again, continuing their winning streak. Yesterday's match, 3-2. Today, 5-0. So we'll see what other teams want to challenge the Glow team. So it should be some good matches in the future. Okay. Alrighty, everybody. Thank you for joining us, and we shall see you next time. Cheers.
Take care.